second. And I just wanted to welcome everybody to this webinar today. You know, sure, everybody's got a busy schedule. And so we'll definitely want to be able to present you guys with, you know, some important information to really help you be able to kind of maximize your time here, as well as kind of see what Review Wave can do for you and your practice. So I think many of us have learned over the past 18 months that the key to, you know, maintaining and obtaining new patients is definitely the patient experience. So with an increased adoption of telehealth, right, what a patient experience has changed pretty drastically in such a short time. And so with that, you know, increased focus on patient experience, you're seeing that there's a growing need for you all as practices, you know, to obtain new patients or maintain relationships with those you already have. And ultimately, right, the key to any healthcare practice is to ensure that patients get better. And so with that being said, you know, at DrChrono and why we think, you know, Review Wave has been such a good partner, I'm not only a DrChrono, but of our customers, as they have, you know, done quite well in providing a set of tools and resources for practices to really kind of adapt to the changing environment, but at the same time, you know, really support, you know, whether you're a telehealth only practice or a hybrid, or, you know, you're still that brick and mortar practice that you've always been in the community to which you live in. So I will ask you all just to welcome Matt Prados. He is the co-founder of Review Wave. And so he's going to be walking us through some key areas of, you know, the patient experience as a whole and kind of how tools like Review Wave can set your practice up for growth. And kind of help you adapt to the new environment to which you're now going to be, you know, obtaining and, you know, maintaining patient relationships. So, Matt, pleasure to have you on the webinar today. Oh, and sorry, Matt, you're muted. If you can unmute. Sorry about that.
No worries. Thanks, Dan. Glad to be here.
Perfect. So I'm sure, you know, what we're going to do is we're going to just walk through some key items that should be kind of in the forefront of your brain when it comes to, you know, what it means to be a practice in 2021. And so with, you know, without any further ado, you know, we've all learned that there's, you know, online scheduling is not just limited to healthcare. You can schedule an appointment for pretty much any service these days online. And so with that, right, like, there needs to be a level of engagement that it is important for these patients to be able to book online. So Matt, have you seen like your online features at Review Wave? You know, what's the best tool set, you know, that your patients are seeing, the patients are seeing from that online scheduling features of Review Wave?
Yeah, absolutely. So a little bit of history before I kind of go into the simpleness of the features is, you know, we started about 5 years ago, simply focusing on reviews. What we did is we watched all of the feedback that our clients got, and it was actually the single biggest area of upset that patients would have was the difficulty in scheduling, whether it was, you know, being on hold or the office wasn't answering the phone or it was after hours or whatever it may be. And so we started digging into, you know, what would true online scheduling look like for a medical practice. You know, it's pretty obvious with like, you know, open table or whatever for a restaurant, you know, you need it in real time. You need to see what's available. You need, it's a couple clicks away, very easy to move through, basic contact information, et cetera. And so we tested a whole different slew of things. And, you know, the most successful thing for online scheduling of new patients is to have a very simple widget on your website, not a portal to log into, because then they have to register for the portal, right? You don't have to register as a user of OpenTable or these various things before scheduling your actual appointment, right? So the idea was, how do we make as few steps as possible? How do we get the highest possible conversion rates? Because, you know, clients are already paying a digital marketing agency, AdWords, Facebook, whatever it may be, to get traffic to their website. The problem is it's not converting as high as they want. And so our online scheduler is the absolute least amount of steps possible to get real-time scheduling. So real appointment availability from DrChrono to the website enough information from the patient to choose the right appointment type and actually schedule and put it into DrChrono right there on the calendar. And so that was the key challenge that we tackled. And basically what we found is that most clients have like a request an appointment form on their website. And that's very typical. And really what that is usually it's a digital marketing agency saying they do online scheduling, but it's really just a request form. Once we swapped out the request an appointment with the schedule appointment feature, we found that 2 to 3 times more new patients would book online with the same website, the same ad spend, the same budgets, the same agencies, everything. So it was really a great hypothesis and it paid off in huge dividends for our clients.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. In regards to, you know, that conversion on the online scheduling, right? I know using like OpenTable, like you had said, right? Likely those restaurants are going to be like calling, you know, the person who's making that reservation to be like, are you still coming? And just confirming that. And right, a lot of practices probably don't have the bandwidth of people in the office to deal with that. So, you know, I'm not, you know, telling state secrets over here, but, you know, texting has become pretty much a, you know, primary source of communication, not just, you know, for any age bracket. You know, there was this underlying belief that, you know, older people couldn't text, and you can tell that to the rest of my, you know, grandparents and mom and dad. But, you know, with that, right, businesses now are having this new platform of communication. And with that platform of communication, right, how is ReviewWave helping out in keeping that easy to use, but at the same time, allowing for some, you know, more high, you know, higher touch point interactions with staff and their patients.
Absolutely. So one quick way to kind of pre-frame this before we move on to the act of texting, which is absolutely the most vital communication tool for any office, is the second part of what most people lump in online scheduling is existing patients, right? How do your existing patients get to schedule or reschedule appointments? Typically, they're forced to call into the office. And so the majority of the front desk time is wasted with phone calls of when is my next appointment? Or can I move it, you know, ahead an hour or back an hour or whatever it may be. And so once we perfected online scheduling for the website for new patients, we saw that, you know, offices wanted to allow existing patients to schedule. So we actually created an app for that. And when you do that, it actually cuts the phone time of the office in about half. So it does allow for more important tasks like following up on the new patients to schedule to make sure they are going to arrive. So that was one crucial point there. But as we move into the texting portion, as you mentioned, so with texting, it is the most used mobile app across all smartphones, both Android and Apple operating systems. And it's upwards of 98% of text messages get open and read, and the majority of them in the first 3 minutes of receiving them. So when you move from, you know, email or even calling, I mean, you know, I think we're all guilty of declining calls, even from family, you know, sorry, mom, but it happens. You know, it's just, you're busy. You don't want to take the huge amount of time for a conversation. And so texting, it's fast. It's quick. You look at it, you know, people are learning to communicate in less words. And so with what we call business texting is you're using your actual office number to send and receive text messages. And so what we do at ReviewWave is literally turn your front desk computer into a smartphone so that your business number can be used. It's not, you know, email to text. It doesn't matter what provider they're using. You don't have to know if it's Verizon, AT&T, or whatever. It doesn't matter. You don't have reduced deliverability because of their carrier or any of that kind of stuff. They're more familiar with their your number because it's already in their phone, most likely. The way we set it up with the initial text they get, most of the more recent phones will identify it as your office. So then anytime any future text will come, it'll say that it's from your office. you can send videos in text, like the link to a YouTube video or whatever, and they can actually see the thumbnail of the video and play it right there in the thread. So all of these different things make business texting an absolute must, because it elevates their experience, seeing the number, understanding the number it's coming from, more familiarity. It will increase your show rate of kept appointments, therefore decreasing your lost time on the missed appointments, which is time that you can never get back. So business texting, one of the single most important areas of a practice, when you add in automation of appointment reminders with business texting, or missed appointment notifications. So if the patient is 15 minutes late, we can automate a text that goes out to them about, you know, having missed their appointment rather than having to have your staff call them. So that's where business texting really comes into play in streamlining your practice.
Awesome. And then, so a patient's booked online, right? And they've, you know, maybe communicated with the practice via text. The next step, right, as I'm sure waiting rooms in offices, or if you're in a virtual waiting room, right, there's going to be limited space, both for safety and just strictly from just how practices are going to have to adapt. I know ReviewWave provides a digital form solution that can kind of assist with collecting data on patients. If you want to just kind of speak like how that works and why that's important to a practice.
Absolutely. So, I mean, most people today have gotten away from having a printer in their office or in their home, excuse me. And so when you send them forms in PDF format that have to be printed, it's a pain point. A lot of times they're photocopied and re-photocopied and they're smeared and, you know, they're not great looking. So it really reduces your image to this prospective new patient. So with our digital forms, we wanted to make them very simple, very streamlined. The patient can fill them out online. You can have e-signatures on them. You can have multiple choice questions, and we can take you know, some of the basic demographic information, write it right back in, and then you get a saved copy of the PDF, which is in your review of application and can also be written into the EHRs. And so it allows them to fill it out on their phone, on their computer, whatever it may be, on their time. So what we always recommend is after they schedule online, or even if they schedule over the phone, to have an automated follow-up sequence with a welcome email that has a link to your digital forms. And so again, another item that your front desk usually does is write an email to the new patient and copy and paste a bunch of stuff and whatnot. With us, you can have a template. There's no more copy paste. There's auto-generated links. It sends right out. And it just makes the whole process much, much easier to have a higher influx of new patients and you know, process them more smoothly.
Yeah, that's awesome. I will say at DrChrono, we've definitely seen an influx of providers and practices looking to have that. Here's a link that you can go fill out your information without the friction of a patient portal. So that's great. Moving on to your scheduling app, I know you had briefly touched on it earlier. You know, why is this so important for retaining patients, and what, you know, what else can it provide beyond just your standard, you know, rescheduling or just, you know, basic check-in?
Yeah. So you can have your dependents in here. If everybody wants to come in at the same time, you can schedule yourself and any mixture or just some of the dependents, but multiple for the same appointment type at the same time. So it can really save your patients a lot of time, but they get to see all of the upcoming appointments. There is a secure messaging aspect here. So because the scheduling app is a login required app versus just text messaging where it just pops up on their phone and anybody can see it. This would be a HIPAA compliant messaging platform as well. And you get your basic office information. So at any time, a patient can go onto their app, they can see their upcoming appointments, and they can reschedule if you allow them. They can cancel if you allow that, or they can schedule new appointments. All of this is 100% customizable inside a ReviewWave, so it can fit the office's business hours and whatever they need, while still, you know, using your business rules just like your staff would if they called. So the big thing here is it's super easy for patients to schedule or reschedule, And like I said, it's going to cut down on about 50% of the phone calls into your office, which allows your staff to spend time attending to the people that are actually in office and give a better patient experience to them.
Awesome. So taking one step back from the practice app, I think Review Wave has definitely seen it, and that's why you guys started in the review area of ensuring a good online presence. Can you kind of just speak to why that's so important, just in general, but also why that importance has only increased, and kind of what Review Wave has done to ensure that your practice is presented as best as possible online?
Yeah, so we'll get into our review features in depth here in a little bit, but basically the key function here with each of these features or benefits that our clients get to provide to their patients is that the patient is going to be wowed each step of the way. You know, if you put in each of these items and you program the technology to act the way you want it to be, and you make their life easier, they're going to experience a better healthcare with you than they would if they're upset that it's hard to schedule an appointment, or that it's difficult to, you know, call in and talk to somebody, or, you know, your front desk is having a bad day and, you know, broke up with a boyfriend or whatever it may be, and then gives them a little attitude. You know, the app's never going to give them attitude, right? And so the bottom line is they're gonna love it. They're gonna love you, and you know that when you have patients that are not only getting great healthcare, which I assume that you all are providing the top notch healthcare, if you also couple that with the best patient experience, the number of referrals that you're gonna get is going to increase, and you're gonna get more patients that pay, stay, and refer.
Awesome. In regards to the, like you said, those reviews. So, right, you're building your presence online, you're engaging with your patients, whether that's through the app or through texting. As a provider now who now is dealing with like changes to where am I seeing patients? How am I seeing patients? You know, how can Review Wave, or why is it important to have something that can move with you, like a mobile app for a provider?
So I'll jump into the provider app in just one second. But before we go into that, I did want to cover reviews a little bit deeper here. So as you build that online presence that you were talking about, you know, more and more people, you see them at the restaurant, and what do they have? They have their phone, and they're engaged with their phone, but not the people that they're eating dinner with, right? The truth is communication between people has gone down in the real world quite a bit if you just look around and you see all of the mobile devices. And so as a practice owner, you have to realize that referrals is now more online reviews than it's ever been in the past. You know, 84% of people, I mean, that's almost 9 out of 10 people trust online reviews as much as a personal referral, right? That's absolutely massive. If you don't have enough reviews, one of the last studies, you know, showed if you don't have at least double digit reviews, people don't trust you, period. You could have 9 5-star reviews. They're not going to trust you because you don't have at least 10, right? But these days, reviews are prevalent. And so depending on your specialty, you might need 100 reviews to just be in the conversation in the top three. If somebody Googles, you know, your vertical, whether it be, you know, chiropractic, dermatology, you know, podiatry, whatever you're in, if they Google that word and your town, there's three local businesses that show up in what's called the Google Maps. The top three show on the first page. If you're not on the first page, you almost don't exist. So you got to look at, what do my competitors have? If they have 200, you got to be better than 200. So it's not a one size fits all number here on how many reviews you need. But, you know, in chiropractic, I would say it's at least, you know, 100 plus to really be in the game. You know, in different verticals, it will vary, you know, from bit to bit, but it's going to be a dynamic number. It's not, there's no destination. It's going to be a journey, because you're always going to be in a race against your competitors with how many reviews you have, as well as the rating. You got to have at least a 4.7 rating. If you're at 5.0 and you're worried about getting, you know, down to 4.9, that's not going to change anything. What's going to change it is the number of reviews. So you definitely got to focus on this, and then use these reviews at every corner or every place that you can. Put them in emails to new patients. Have them plastered on your glass, you know, as people are walking into your office for the first time. If you have a TV in your waiting room, have them playing on the TV in the waiting room. You know, just have them in every possible place because they're telling a story about how they had success with you. So if a potential patient sees a review from somebody who's just like them that they can relate to, their defenses of like, the doc's going to try to sell me something or whatever are going to be much lower. Their ability to accept care is going to be much higher simply because the situation's been diffused based on the trust that you've built, the influence that you've built with these reviews. So they are so, so vital. And how do you get the reviews? Each and every one of the functions that we've talked about add up to, you know, part of the experience, and that will add up to reviews for sure. But one of the ways is, you know, when you're out of the office, most of the time you've got an answer machine that, you know, people barely leave messages for, or if they do, you're calling back, you know, as many as 3 days later, if they call on a Friday and you don't call until Monday. A lot of times they'll go on to the next office. They want instant gratification. They want to get whatever it is handled now. And so with the provider app, what we did is we actually gave you the ability to take your texting on the go. So if somebody messages you at your business number, you can get an alert on this app so that you or your team can immediately respond to that text message if you so desire. It also gives you the ability to schedule or reschedule appointments. So if an existing patient schedules in and says, hey, I would like to go from this time to this time, and for whatever reason, they're not using the scheduling app, you can handle that or your team can handle that in the provider app. And so taking all that on the go, seeing your schedule, you know, in a couple clicks, no matter where you are, is a amazing speed of service that people will not forget. So you definitely want to, you know, have the provider app with you at all times so you and your team can handle those items outside of work hours.
All right. As we come down to the dashboard, I know not everything can be done through a mobile app on a phone. And sometimes you need that big picture view. And I know with the Review Wave application, there's definitely some opportunities to kind of get a big picture as how you're doing as a practice. And just to kind of speak to that, have you seen, you know, what have you seen as a successful usage of the dashboard with Review Wave customers? And ultimately, you know, where is this really helping out at the practice level?
Yeah, well, on any practice management level, you got to look at, you know, what you track, you can monitor and improve. And so in a scenario of a, you know, a high volume practice or, you know, whatever, you know, volume you may be, you got to look at, you know, where are you now? Compare it to where you've been, and then figure out what actions you did to make it go up or what actions happened to make it go down, and figure out how to remedy it. And so really on the fly, we track all these things with you. We get them all dialed in and give you the ability to just at a glance, look at, you know, where is everything? How's it going? Is it going well? Is it up? Is it down? And then, you know, you take the individual actions to focus on, you know, whatever the biggest win is should always be the first thing. But, you know, long-term, you can really use these to achieve your goals because we're automatically tracking these for you.
And what do you think are some key metrics that like you should just keep an eye on that are present in the dashboard, but like what are good value or not the values themselves, but what are key things you should keep an eye on?
Sure. So, the basics are always going to be total patient visits, you know, because you're typically going to have some sort of average appointment value. Your appointment show rate is probably one of the biggest things because once you have a missed appointment and you lose that time, you never get that time back. And so keeping your schedule full, getting that appointment show rate into the 90s and, you know, 95 or better will will get you to utilize the majority of your time. Obviously, you have to make sure appointments are on the books. If you only have one appointment and you get 100% show rate, it's not really doing the job. So you compare it to other things. But in any business, collections is going to be vital. Is the money coming in the door? Because you could do, 2,000 visits a week. But if you don't have any money coming in the door, that's a problem. So no one size fits all. And obviously, each industry will be a little bit different. But those would be the three key ones that I would recommend that everybody keep an eye on. And then, of course, we've got the review stats. How are your reviews going? How are you growing them, over time? And, being able to use them to get more new patients, more patient visits, more collections.
Awesome. So just shifting the focus a little bit. So all the tools that can, whether it's the online scheduling, the texting, the reviews, Review Wave has a nice tool set to actually help ultimately the core goal of better patient care through better patient experience. And so with that, right, how do the care plans factor into that for staff and clinicians alike?
Yeah. So depending on obviously the vertical that you're in, you have different care plans for your patients. With a dentist, it may be, one or two appointments. With a chiropractor, it may be 36 to 60 visits, and anything in between. But if you need to track, are your patients staying on the cadence? Are they showing up for the appointments you're doing? You can easily input these care plans into Review Wave, and then your staff gets this portal, which we call Mission Control. They get to see if there's any patients coming in that are behind on their care plans, any patients that missed appointments the day before, any patients that aren't confirmed for their appointments today, and use this to-do list, if you will, of items so that they can make sure that you have as few no-shows and as high compliance to whatever your care plan situation may be. And it's a real game changer to stop losing these appointments, because if you need a patient to get 10 visits for whatever it may be, and they only come eight, they're only getting 80% of your care plan, which is lost income for you, lost health care gains for them, et cetera. And so care plans are a vital piece of keeping that all buttoned up together.
And you mentioned that Mission Control. And so I know, that seems to be a great opportunity for the day-to-day, almost your checklist of things to do. Any other, where are you finding practices leveraging the Mission Control beyond just the care plans?
If we're honest here, we got to say that the number of items that the average front desk team has to handle, it's pretty astronomical. You have to be able to think on the go. You have to know everything that's going on at any given time. And so Mission Control really, gives them the ability to look back at key items that they need to make sure get handled for the day. It can be used in a morning huddle or throughout the day. Additionally, because we have the business texting conversation page, which is 99% open all day long by the team, we send alerts. So, let's say, hey, Dan's got an appointment, in 15 minutes, and he's, one visit behind on his care plan. We'll actually throw an alert into the conversations page, which is where the staff hangs out most of the time, saying, hey, Dan's going to be here in 15 minutes and he's got one makeup visit to schedule, right? So we'll actually tell the team in real time, 15 minutes prior to the patient's arrival, what, if anything, is needed with that patient.
Oh, awesome. So it definitely feels like you getting the right information at the right time to make sure everything gets handled and you're not, like you said, once you lose time, you can't get it back. It's the one thing that doesn't, resource that doesn't come back for sure. Perfect. So getting patients into the door, right? I'm sure like most of you, most of us have some unread emails in our inbox for sure on our phones or on our computers right now. And so with that, right, you have to be able to stand out against the crowd. And I know there's probably a bevy of email editing tools that can help out with that, but having something included in your patient engagement platform, as a former clinician and a practice manager myself, I can tell you this is vital in ensuring that you're catching someone's eye. So how does the Review Wave, how does that assist with some of the more, creative pieces of patient engagement that could be important?
Yeah, so a lot of practices like to send out monthly newsletters or announcements and do, you know, have some nice images, et cetera. And, you know, you'd have to typically use like a MailChimp or, you know, one of these things as kind of an add-on. You'd have to upload your list and whatnot. And so what we did in building this out, so it's fully mobile responsive, drag and drop editor. You can access thousands of stock photos. You can upload your own photos. We've got some custom widgets to display your reviews because we definitely recommend that you should display your reviews and whatnot. But the bottom line is you want to be able to, you know, there's certain people that are going to read emails. There's certain people that are only going to read texts. There's certain people you're going to have to still call. And, you know, you want to be able to serve each of those people in whatever form that they want. And so having, you know, a real beautiful email editor that makes easy designing of your emails that people can read again on their smartphone, because the smartphone is probably where they're going to read it, is vital to get your message out, whether it's an event you're having or, you know, just simply, you know, showcasing some patients for the month and what's happening in the office, et cetera. You want it to look nice.
Yeah, I know that can be quite important there. And then, so you've offered, you know, a plethora of opportunities to engage with patients, right? I think some of us have a tough time putting the phone down, you know, because you want to engage with patients. That's why you're a clinician or you're working in healthcare. And so in those times when, you know, not everybody can be awake 24 hours, what's like how, I know you guys have some after hours tool sets and kind of like, how does that play into the engagement experience and how can that be vital just to maintaining patients as well?
Yeah. So you want to make sure that you're, patients have as many different channels to communicate as possible, right? So if they end up calling and you don't answer, then at the end of the day, you know, you chance losing that patient forever, even. And so what we found after doing some call tracking and monitoring on some of our clients' websites with the existing marketing that they already have, everything they're already doing, we found that they were missing dozens and dozens of calls each and every month. And so what we made here in what we call Charlie AI is basically a answer machine in the cloud. However, it integrates with DrChrono in the fact that when somebody calls in, we check that incoming phone number against DrChrono's contacts. If that number exists, we know it's an existing patient, we'll play one message. If the number doesn't exist, we'll actually assume they're a new patient and we'll play a different kind of message. And so you're going to more properly give the right message to the right person at the right time. Then they get to leave a message. However, if they leave a message or don't leave a message, again, based on whether we recognize the phone number or we don't and assume it's a new patient, we're going to automate a text message to that person, again, with proper messaging. Now, why is this important? A majority of people aren't going to leave a voicemail. But if you hit them with a text apologizing for missing the call and, you know, getting them engaged in a text message, they're now not calling the next provider in a list. They're actually engaged with you. So here you can have some automated text responses. You can have the mobile app on your phone where the team gets alerted and then they can respond to it, whatever it may be. But you're going to capture this person's attention longer and have a better chance of getting them into your office for the treatment that they were looking at from you. So vital thing to add on top. And, you know, we've seen it pick up as many as, you know, a dozen more patients per month for some clinics, which is a huge amount of income that they were losing prior to this kind of a service.
Wow. Those are some definitely important numbers for sure. In regards to say a patient, like you said, online presence is very important. If you're not in that top three, you might as well not exist. So say somebody finds you through their online presence, you know, through a link on Google, and then they come to your webpage and then anybody can get to a webpage at any time of the day, you know, this ability to communicate in the least, I guess, friction possible with the potential patient. How do you guys support that with your web chat functionality?
Yeah, so we specifically named it web chat, not live chat. And for the very reason that live chat is done in a browser to browser kind of scenario. And so, you know, if you go to a website and you start a live chat and they don't answer in time and you get bored and you leave that browser, they have no further way to contact you unless the form that started the live chat asked for some contact information. And so what we did, instead of doing the browser-to-browser scenario, we actually start the live chat or the web chat, excuse me, by asking for the person's name, cell phone number, and then the message. And so once they hit the send button for the message to go through, that comes across in the conversations tab where the office during office hours is already, you know, hanging out so they can easily respond. But if not, if it's after hours and you get the text again, it's on your smartphone, you can, you know, respond via there, and the prospect will get a text message response so they can leave the browser and be gone and still get a response from you in the most appropriate method, which is texting. And so, you know, why would somebody use web chat versus pick up the phone or schedule online? Personal preference. So again, if you can give enough people their what they would like to do, so you give them a phone, maybe it's late at night, they know you're not going to answer, but they see a chat thing, they might be more likely to do that. They have a question, they want to know something before they schedule with you online. Maybe you take my insurance, your website's not clear, it doesn't say, whatever it may be. But, you know, again, you give enough little mouse traps, as they're called in marketing a lot of times, but, you know, ways or lines of communication, you're going to get more patients coming in the front door, which is your goal, so that you can serve as many people at the top level as possible.
Awesome. And then I just had a question regarding, so like you said, that online presence, finding patients that are similar to you. And so I'm thinking that from a practice to, you know, determining if Review Wave is good for them. Any success stories that either you think would be great to talk about, or any way they can go find potential success stories that might fit their type of practice, like a chiropractic or like you said, like a dentistry office.
As far as successes using Review Wave or just for their patients?
For using Review Wave.
For using us, sure. So, you know, if you go to our website, reviewwave.com, and you just scroll down a little bit, we've got, about 100 video testimonials of doctors from all over the US and Canada talking about different features and functions of Review Wave that have, you know, really changed their practice, changed their lives, taken away stress, you know, increased their volumes, et cetera. So plenty of ways to check us out, and we do a free consultation. So if you go to our website, you click on the, you know, schedule a demo button, you know, one of our guys will walk through all the features, walk through what you're doing with your practice, what needs you may have. Obviously, we have a full integration with DrChrono. Everything is really run seamlessly, and so much of it will just work out of the box for you that, you know, will literally, you know, blow your mind on what can be done.
Awesome. Yeah, I can say as a DrChrono employee who has worked with customers before, being able, like you said, to see someone else like them have success with a partner has been pretty vital in helping people understand where that value is. And speaking about value, just, you know, long-term, any things we should be on the lookout for when it comes to the integration, some potential new areas that might interest customers who are, you know, on the fence?
Lots of interesting things coming. I can't let the cat out of the bag on the one that would absolutely be the biggest. But, you know, the bottom line with the integration with Chrono is anything that your staff does via email or text or greeting card more than once can be automated, and that can be done right now. So, you know, don't look at Review Wave as a cost increased overhead, that kind of stuff. It really is a investment that you will get returns on pretty much immediately. In the first 30 days, you'll see it. You know, we're so confident in our platform. We have a 60-day satisfaction guarantee. So I don't know any other company in our in the swimming pool that we swim in that does that kind of a guarantee. So, you know, that should speak volumes.
Awesome. And I will say, in looking at their website and guiding people there, very easy to get set up to speak with the team over at Review Wave to kind of answer your questions and see if it's a right fit for your practice. So I will tell you, it is a very easy way to find out more about them. So we've covered most of the items, you know, most of the topics about how Review Wave and their tool set and kind of how that's going to make you be present online, but at the same time, make you still feel as an engaging, you know, practice for your patients. Any questions from the audience, feel free to type those in the chat now. I'll give it about 10 to 15 seconds or so. I know for us over on the DrChrono side, I can speak volumes about how Review Wave has really helped out those practices who were having a tough time over the past, you know, few months or so, trying to get new patients, trying to retain patients because either their doors were closed or they were switching to an online only model and their patients weren't getting communicated that. So I can say, you know, very firmly that Review Wave has grown pretty exponentially over the recent past, which has just shown how easy their features are and just how easy it is to work with them. So I just wanted to leave, you know, give my pitch as to why I think Review Wave has been pretty vital in keeping some of our practices afloat, you know, as we transition out of COVID. But we don't have any questions in the chat. Again, if you have any questions at all, just like Review Wave offers for the practices, they do have a web chat functionality on their website, as well as that, you know, you can book a demo as well. If you have any DrChrono questions as it relates to integration, feel free to reach out to partners at drchrono.com and we can answer those questions there. But I want to thank everybody for joining on the call today and for everybody listening once this gets uploaded to our social media channels as well. And Matt, thank you for taking time out of your busy day. You know, I very much appreciate all the time that you spent with us today. So again, thank you very much. Appreciate it. And hope everybody has a great rest of their day.
Thanks, Dan. You too. Cheers.
Bye, guys.